I'm David Nour. Over the past two decades, I've become passionate about working with global P&L leaders to create innovative new net growth opportunities. Here are just a few examples of hundreds we've been able to work with.
I'm Chad Johnson.
I'm Kathy Bedell.
I'm Jeff Carney.
I'm Ray Harris.
I'm Casey Choi, Executive Vice President and General Manager for Samsung Mobile.
I'm the Chief Procurement Officer for Humana.
Senior Vice President of BCD Travel.
CEO of iJam Financial.
And I'm the CIO for AdTrend.
So what's the common thread between all these executives? They're all trying to challenge the status quo in their teams, in their organizations, in their industries, think and lead in new innovative ways, and take advantage of new potential market opportunities.
Every time that I've gone to him with something that we didn't know or we needed to get involved in, he knew exactly either where to go or had a lot of experience with it. He's a perfect phone a friend when it comes to subjects you're not aware of.
He can take complex things and then really make them easy for people to understand. And I love the way he thinks differently from everybody else.
He is very relevant. He has stayed relevant, and he is a generalist. He can talk about any industry sector and get you to think about things in a different way.
It's not just the pitch or the charisma, which, you know, those things are important. I think the thing that stands out for me for David is really the methodology and the technique and really the deep research he puts into his domains of expertise.
So why the Nour Group team? Why now? And how can we help in this new digital environment?
The global pandemic has caused havoc in our health ecosystem. More pressed for time, we're asked to do more with less. Our time, effort, commitments are constrained. Nour gets that.
A lot of what we're seeing right now is crisis management. I think David has applied a lot more methodology and thinking around this, and it's been driven through I think years of honing the art of the relationship, and that has become I think key in his approach.
You know, the fact that we were able to do this during this trying time, right, when, like I said, most folks were shutting things down and looking at canceling projects. The fact that he was innovative enough to be able to say, hey, we can continue to do this and do it remotely and do it virtually was kind of critical.
Look, I'm not new to the digital game. As a matter of fact, we were doing webinars almost 10 years ago. Our podcast has thousands of listeners. We're using digital whiteboards to immerse people into a common collaboration, communication, and if not a co-creation environment. Digital is more than just taking your content online. It's about thinking very differently about how to create engagement and influence their thinking and their call to action.
You know, it's fantastic. As a matter of fact, when we left the event, our group actually wanted to get David or send him a video. Thank you. Which we've had quite a few speakers, but I've never had anybody do that. And we've had follow-up, we said follow-up from it, and we're still doing it to this day, where David had recommended things for us to do. Everybody follows him now and talks about him quite often. So the experience was great, but it wasn't a one-time experience. It really has gone on for a long period of time for us.
I think that's one of the key aspects that I've always appreciated about it, about working with David, is it's not just about the wow of the moment. It's about the ability to follow through on that with, you know, time-tested and proven capabilities.
Don't be on the fence. You will absolutely never regret getting him involved and getting engaged with him.
If comments by these executives and a glimpse into how we engage and influence and work with our clients resonates with you, I'd love to talk to you and learn more about your journey from now to next and how our team can become an enabler of your success.